Hi, so I'm with John Rolfe. Thank you. Thank you for joining me and for being keen to share. I know that when we last met, you shared one or two small things that you did on a very special trip to India that had significant benefits for you. Would you like to tell us more?
Yeah, it was a trip of a lifetime, life-changing really. And it was a friend of mine as well that came with me, and it was a motorcycle trip to the Himalayas. So it was going up to the highest point in terms of navigable roads. And through a country which was well known, should we say, for problems and stomach issues. So as part of the planning, we just wanted to make it the best it could possibly be. So both he and I visited a clinical nutritionist, and we had a session in terms of how do we prevent getting bad gut bacteria within India, because it was known that everybody goes there, they have problems. So we had the consultations. She had a look at us. She did the questionnaires. She looked at all the medication that we were on and tailored a program in terms of what we should be doing when we went over there. So when we went over there, it was very much a daily regime of the support that we took. And there were a couple of things that resonates with me along the way. There was a group of, 30 of us doing the motorcycle trip over the Himalayas. And every day there was two things. There was two awards. One was Dick of the Day, which you can imagine what that sort of thing was. But it was the most stupid event during the day. And I can remember one guy, he's a Canadian, trying to start his motorcycle. And it was a kickstart motorcycle. So he got off the motorcycle, left it in gear, tried to kickstart it. And there are sewers down the side of the road in India. And he kickstarted his bike into the roadside sewer. So that was one Dick of the Day award. But the other awards were really, it was a toilet seat. A toilet seat was awarded to somebody in the group who had a problem with their stomach, because it was expected.
Okay.
And my friend and I went through the whole 2-week experience without a problem. Everybody else was through the eye of a needle, shall we say. And my friend and I came out of it with our gut health intact, and we had a fantastic time. We didn't even have the stomach cramps or the people getting all the time. So it was a huge benefit to visit our professional before we went, to do the planning, to get the support required, knowing what we were going to be up against there. Yeah. And we came back having a fantastic time and in full gut health.
And can I ask you two things? Did you ever feel, firstly, that you were excluded or losing out? I mean, did you still eat with the others? Okay.
Yeah, we ate exactly the same stuff as the others. We had street food. We were transacting with the local money. Everything we did was exactly the same as everybody else.
And secondly,
was
it because you were taking some kind of supplement? So you boosted your gut health.
So it was an additive to water that killed the bad gut bacteria, all the bad things coming in, and then it was the supplements which then supported the good bacteria. And just by those two things coming together, did exactly what we needed it to do.
That's fantastic. And the application into daily life is that many of us could benefit from getting some advice and preparing for thinking about our gut health to help us, not just when we're perhaps in a place where we're more prone to getting ill, but even today.
It was about planning ahead and asking somebody who knows what they're talking about, getting the advice and following it to the letter. And that's exactly what we did.
Thank you. As a true leader should, you find a strategy that works and then you stick to the strategy.
Absolutely.
Thank you, John, for sharing that. I really appreciate that you were happy to share your tiny habit. And may you have many more of those trips and never get the toilet seat.
Absolutely. Yeah, one a year. That's what we do, one a year.
Fantastic. Thank you.
Pleasure.